I can't have no sympathy for fuck, nigga. All the shit I seen done made my blood thicker. Spill promethazine inside a double cup. Double up my cream, now that's a double step. Yeah.
Please don't hit my phone if it ain't about no commas. Keep the peace like Dalai Lama, big body hummer.
Larkin, yes. What do you hope to do with dance?
Project Home. I think sitting next to two people who've done so much in their dance lives, I think like I want to continue to push in that direction. Chris, Martin, and myself have been working on Project Home for the last 3 years. We just finished our first film and our first tour with a show. And working with working with hundreds of dancers all over the world, China, Russia, Australia, Europe, all over the place. And I want to continue to do that. Something about when you find a project or a cause to work on that just like almost picks you. You don't always like get to pick it. It picks you, and it just like tells you what feels right, and it shows you that that's what you're supposed to be doing. And throughout the whole process of creating Project Home and performing in Project Home, every part of it was the most difficult thing I've ever done, but also told me to keep doing it. And so that's what I want to do.
Hi. What's the first thing you do when you get choreo block?
There's actually a really great piece it's on YouTube, but it's by this guy named Ira Glass. He runs This American Life. It's like a radio thing. If you're interested in, just search Ira Glass, I-R-A Glass, and then put in work, and then watch that video. What he talks about is that as artists, like when we're growing and becoming more experienced, we have a sense of taste, of like artistic taste, but without experience, you kind of fall short of what your taste is. Right? Like all of us know what looks good. All of us know what feels good. And when we watch it, or like when we watch Kinjas, you're like, whoa, that's a great example of artistry at work. Or even when you watch Dom in class, it's a great example of artistry at work. And you see that where you want to get to. But to get to that point, the only thing you can do is just put in work. Like keep making stuff. So when it comes to something like choreo block, or any artistic block, whether that's in regards to creating choreography or a concept or editing, when you come to a point where you're like, the only thing you can do is like push in, I think, and keep working. That's the only thing. Show up, I think. Show up. Yeah.
Am I allowed to piggyback shit?
Dude, go ahead, man.
Yeah. Like, if you think of choreo block literally as like a block in your road of progression, like just a fucking wall stops right here as you're trying to move forward. You either literally, you got two options. You break through or you walk around it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So like you might not necessarily be what you think is the same flow you might want to go. You're either gonna push through and literally like put muscle to it, and that works sometimes for some people. Or you just change your train of thought to just get past it and you'll find your flow again to your foundational intention. So, yeah. It's literally a block. You
know? Also, piggybacking on top of that as well. Double.
One, two.
That sounds like a hamburger. Double piggyback.
That is special.
Yeah.
2 weeks.
I'm hungry. Like, we can push in and push through and like work towards something and at something, but I also think like turning around and walking the other way is also going forward. And what that might literally look like is like, if you worked on a piece of choreography, like turning around and like trying something the total opposite direction, I think is also a way in which to move forward, even though it might feel like backwards. So.
piggyback.
All right, Larkin, how do you take your tall height into account when you dance?
Sorry, I was asking
him a question because mine was a little bit more.
He said, "How's your tall ass move so well?"
Is that the question?
Yeah, but it was like,
oh, how do you take your tall height into account when you dance?
Yeah, it was nice. I calculate. Just do it.
What Larkin is trying to say,
yeah,
is when he was younger and learning dance, there were times when being too tall made things more difficult. But then once you actually learn that because you're more lengthy, to be able to do the same things actually made them moves more powerful. So once you accepted the true strength of it, you push harder, you know what I mean? And you use it to your advantage versus your disadvantage.
I also like, for a long time, just kick back. No, I also for a long time danced right here. Like, sit. And like, for the longest time I did that, and I think I took Jillian's class, and she's like, what are you doing? Because she'd be teaching these pieces, but she's like, yeah, right? Just like going all over, and I was like, Jillian's class, also taking ballet for many years, just like opened me up and made me be like, oh, cool, like I can use this and it can be fun. And I don't know. Also, just like don't overthink it. Just like dance, have a good time. I don't know.
Yeah. All right, Larkin.
Yeah.
How important do you think it is to know the lineage of a certain style or move/movement?
I think it's greatly important. I think it's extremely important to know where these things come from. I feel a lot for that. First of all, because it's respectful, I think, and second of all, because it's so cool to learn about. I remember taking a West African dance class in college. And then like I did a lot of ballet, took a few like modern and contemporary classes, and also like dance philosophy and history classes. And learning about lineage, learning about where certain steps come from and where certain concepts come from, and who created something like, who created contact improv, and learning about why the Apache line turned into
the greatest
breakers who like fought against each other without weapons, and learning about all these tiny, tiny things that for most of the world don't mean anything, but for us are really important. I don't know, I have learned a lot of life lessons and gained a lot of knowledge because of so many of those stories. And I also think like storytelling, this what we do is storytelling. And at least the way I look at it is we are storytellers, and we're passing the torch in a lot of ways, whether we know it or not. Because like hopefully all of y'all will teach someone a dance move or two, and you know, hopefully that keeps going. And like you commented, or we were talking about earlier, like. Or both of you were both talking about, like, we do these dance moves, these things all together, and for some reason it like feels good.
Yeah.
Like, we don't need to, you know, like, dancing isn't always a necessary thing, like for our evolution or in our lives, it's not like we need to do it to survive, but for some reason we still do, and knowing how and why and where those things come from to get to where we are now, I think is just like so intriguing and so incredibly beautiful, and such a privilege and an honor to be a part of that lineage and a part of that story. in some way, whether it's small or big. Yeah, it's everything. It's like, you know, we're all building on those, on those moves, on those silly dance things that people have made up in the past, and I find that to be so beautiful for some reason. I don't know.
All the shit I seen made my blood, nigga. Spill from medicine inside.